Hi there, and welcome to episode 5 of Redefining Success, where you are inspired to do you through eye-opening interviews and life lessons from yours truly, Jen Deal, Doctor of Business and Success Coach. Today, I'm honored to have Lauren Bordelon on the show, and she is not only my friend, but my marketing guru, my marketing wizard, my marketing everything. Lauren is a South Florida native who specializes in marketing and advertising services. Previously, Lauren worked for an advertising agency where she was able to obtain certifications in Facebook advertising and Google advertising, as well as work on major accounts like Michael's Craft Stores. She graduated from Florida Atlantic University with a major in communications and graphic design, and later went on to start her company, LBMG Marketing, where she focuses on helping small businesses and other entrepreneurs with advertising and marketing. Lauren's greatest weakness is hunger, and food is of her main priority, second, of course, to LBMG Marketing. Hey, Lauren, welcome to the show. So nice to have you today.
Hi, Jen. Thanks so much for having me. I'm excited.
So we're going to dig right into talking about redefining success. And so my first question is, what is Lauren's idea of success?
Absolutely. So success can mean many things. And to me, it means being fulfilled by what you do. And for me specifically, flexibility. So, you know, I did the 9-to-5 thing for a really long time. And I thought to myself, I can't sit here and huff and puff about that because fortunately I really didn't have to do it for very long, a couple years, but I knew very quickly it wasn't for me and it was something I wanted to get out of. My first big feeling of career success came from taking my business home full time. And I say career success because I believe that victories in your personal life can relate to success as well, which it's kind of funny. This segues me into my next point about I had a defining moment about a week or two ago where I threw a fit at the gym because my lifts, you know, they weren't going the way I wanted them to. And I was gearing up to leave and I had a conversation with my boyfriend and he really opened my eyes to what I like to call the other side. And the other side is someone who works a 9-to-5, something that I did recently and I did it for a little bit. And he explained that, you know, I have a job, a career where I wake up every day and I'm so excited to do what I do and I'm excited to serve others and help them on their journey to business success. And there's so many people who wake up and they go to their 9-to-5 and they do their work and they go home. And that to them, it's a means to an end. So to me, success is doing something that doesn't feel like a means to an end.
Beautiful. And so you said at the beginning that your idea of success is doing something that fulfills you. So how would you describe that feeling of being fulfilled?
It kind of segues me back to waking up with a fire to really help others. And that feeling of fulfillment is I did something good for someone else. I helped someone else in their business and it's a happy feeling. I just like, you know, you can almost feel it in your heart. It feels really nice.
And that's a perfect segue, speaking of segues, to my next question. How does this feeling of fulfillment, your idea of success, how does this compare to success according to societal standards?
In America, you go to school, then you go to college, and then you graduate college and you get a job. And that's the standard American way. And society preaches that that's the American way. And for a lot of people, I think that ends in them resenting college, resenting their career, working a job that just isn't impactful to them. Mm-hmm. I think when someone finds their true passion, they need to develop it and go after their dreams. And that doesn't always necessarily mean go to college.
That's perfect. And how do you think you came about? What happened for you to find your true passion? And how are you living your success story right now?
You know, like I said before, I wake up every day with a passion to serve other people's businesses. And I go to bed not wanting to go to bed because I want to help other people. And that gets me really fired up. It's really funny because I get super fired up right before I go to bed. And I have to be like, okay, like put your phone away, come back down to earth, you know, like watch some TV or read a book, but I'm still so fired up about helping other people. But, you know, how I came to this, you know, what I wanted to do was, I don't know, it was a series of things. And it just led me to feeling like, you know, I know I'm good at this thing, the advertising marketing, and I want to help other people. So that came to me pretty early on when I was in college, actually.
That's very lucky for you because I think there's probably some folks out there that unfortunately it may take 40 years or 60 years. And so I'm sure you feel fortunate that you were able to discover your passion and this fulfillment at a young age.
Yes. Yeah.
And so how has your past contributed to your present day success story?
Yeah, sure. So I knew from a little kid that I wanted to be important. I didn't want to be doing the dog work for someone else and, you know, putting money into someone else's pockets and not my own. My parents are both entrepreneurs, and my father specifically worked his way up the corporate ladder. So I think essentially ambition is just in my DNA. And as I get older, as I got older, I knew I was leaning more on the creative side of things. So I started failing history and science in the seventh grade. Like it was a no-brainer there. So with the help and support of my family, I really tried everything. I was in theater, newspaper, yearbook. I was editor-in-chief of my high school yearbook, which was so much fun. It's funny because I don't understand how someone could not know what they want to do with their life when they're young, early on, high school, college. But then I have to pull myself back and remind myself, I'm just this lucky lady who is driven by ambition and passion for success.
And I really like what you said, that the ambition is in your DNA. So I feel like everybody has this. They just may not see it right away.
Yeah, absolutely.
I always use this word ordinary, but could you give us a peek into an ordinary day for Lauren?
Sure. So I try and wake up as early as possible, which means I try and go to bed as early as possible. It doesn't always work out, but no matter what, I have my alarm set for 6:30 or 7 a.m. And I like to start as early as I can because I feel the earlier I get my day going, the more I can get done. So I grab a cup of coffee and I make some avocado toast and eggs and I start my day. I try and pause in between a few times a day. I go for a walk and try and get outside. I don't like to be stationary all day. I find myself getting pretty stiff. So going outside and walking around is a huge part of my mental sanity, especially when you're confined to a computer. I usually end my day around 5-6 when I go to the gym. After that, I have some dinner. On a good night, I'll watch Blue Planet or read. Then I go to sleep. I'm pretty routine with this. And honestly, I believe that a routine is a huge part of succeeding and reaching your daily goals.
And, you know, you were talking about the gym, and I know you personally, so I feel like sometimes that time at the gym, you're lifting and things like that, is probably very good for you as a constantly working person. It's a time for you to really take a break from all of that activity going on in your mind. Would you agree?
Absolutely. And actually, it's funny you mentioned that, because the last few weeks I've been struggling in the gym a lot, and I think it's because I've been letting a lot of the outside stressors into the gym instead of leaving it at the door. But I've refocused myself and yeah, I go in there and I'm excited to work towards something different in my life, a different goal, something different than business or health. You know, it's really just me in there focusing on getting stronger and being my best self in the gym.
And it's nice that you're aware of it, that you know that the last few weeks you may have not been present, or you're letting that outside, you know, that the brain keep going into the gym. And so it's nice that you are aware of it, at least to give that space for you to have a well-deserved break for Lauren, the person that's not doesn't stop working or thinking.
That's me.
Yes. And so, Lauren, what message would you like to share with others that are striving to live happier?
Okay, so this comes at a great time. So I'm going to back up a little bit. My grandfather wrote me a letter in 2007. So that's 11 years ago. Mm-hmm. And I read it for the first time 2 weeks ago. I came across it. I didn't know it existed. And it couldn't have come at a more perfect time. He passed away in 2009, and he was honestly my best friend. So I believe I was about 15 or 16 when he passed away. At this time, you know, I was struggling with happiness. 2 weeks ago when I got that letter, and I'm working hard every day to get better at it, but I was struggling with the balance of happiness in my work life and my personal life. But anyways, in this letter, he said, "I hope you set your sights very high, but have fun and do not demand too much of yourself, and love and be loved. It really is a short time frame from your age and the position today to the time when you too will be 78 years old." So what am I getting at here? Time is flying. You know, my parents are getting older. I'm getting older. I want time to slow down. And my advice for happiness is to really cherish every moment that you're not absorbed in work. Smile more. Wake up, you know, every day and say, I'm going to be positive today. Go on walks. Don't bring headphones. Throw your phone in your back pocket and just find something new about the area you're in. And lastly, love. Love as hard as you can. Love where you live. Love your significant other. Love your best friends. Choose to lift those people up around you every single day. You know, like my papa said, it won't be long before I too will be 78 years old and looking back on life. You want to look back and be able to say that you really lived a happy life.
Oh, Lauren, that's so beautiful. I really appreciate you sharing that with the audience and us. And I just feel like that's so beautiful and such a powerful letter, and gave you the message at the perfect time. And you were already in your mind thinking you need to be in the present moment, but this was just what you needed to continue on that path.
Yeah, it was truly, it could not have come at a better time. It was very beautiful.
And so, Lauren, where can folks find you if they're like, oh my gosh, I have to meet Lauren or talk with Lauren? Where can they find you?
Okay, so probably somewhere in Fort Lauderdale eating.
Okay. And wait, let's stop right there. What are you going to be eating when they meet you?
Oh my gosh. Sushi.
Okay, yum.
Okay. Anyway, I'm also on Instagram as the Lauren Bordelon, T-H-E, Lauren Bordelon. My company page is LBMG Marketing on Instagram, or come say hi on my website, www.thelbmgmarketing.com.
Awesome. Lauren, thank you so much for taking the time out of your busy day to join me on this podcast, and I will talk to you soon.
Thanks so much for having me. I'm very excited about it.
If you love this podcast, then subscribe and leave a great review. I will talk to you soon. Much love. Bye for now.